Let's see this problem today, which says that there is a series RLC circuit which consists of a resistance 1 kilo ohm and an inductance of 100 millihenry in series with a capacitance of 10 picofarads. Okay, if 100 volt is applied, you have to determine the following parameters. Understand that? So I'm not dictating the questions to you. Okay. Anyways, in the solution, I'll be explaining everything. You can leave space for the question there. Okay. You can leave space for the question. Okay. Now, let me just write the, it's talking about R, L, C connected in parallel. You can just make a note of this when I'm writing it. Okay. And they're saying that R is 1 kilo ohm. Fine. L is 100 millihenry. Fine. And capacitance is 10 picofarads rather. Okay. And they're saying that if 100 volt supply is connected or 100 volts is applied, we have to determine the frequencies, resonant frequencies. So this is something that you've been doing. Okay, this is also a straightforward problem. Okay, you can see F naught is given by 1 by 2 pi root LC. Okay, substitute the things. 1 by 2 pi L is 100 milli. And capacitor is 10 pico. Pico is how much? Pico is 10 power minus 12. Yes. Nano is 10 power minus 9. Pico is 10 power minus 12. Okay. And if you do that, you'll get your F naught to be 159.15 kilohertz. Just take down this is a straightforward finding, because there's nothing much to think of. Okay, L is given, C is given, and if you know LC, F naught can be easily found out. Understand that point? Now they're asking us the maximum current. Fine. Let me explain you that. See, they are asking us the maximum current, right? Let me take this here. And we should know that maximum current can only be there when the circuit is at resonance. Okay, and what is the impedance of the circuit at resonance? Okay, the impedance of the circuit is R, so it is V by R. Everybody should understand. Otherwise, see here, if you take I, when the circuit is not resonating, it is V by Z. Let me write here. I is equal to V by Z. But since we are writing the maximum current, okay, so it has to be written as V by R. So what could that be given as? Applied voltage is 100 and the resistance given is 1 kilo ohm. So this implies that I naught would be 0.1 amperes. See that every time you find an answer, don't forget to keep them in box. Fine? Because that will highlight your answer. So you should not let your examiners search for it. Okay, soon after they see, they should find. Fine. What is that they have asked next? What is that they have asked? They have asked us to find out the quality factor. What is quality factor given by? Okay, so it is given as third one. They have asked us the quality factor, and they have not asked us quality factor at resonance, but since we have the R, omega, L, we can find out Q naught. Okay, and we can say it is omega naught L by R. Okay, and since you have RL and RC also in series, okay, the quality factor would remain the same whether you take omega L by R or omega naught L by R. Okay, so to make the things easier, so let's not confuse ourselves. Okay, let's just remove that omega naught. Okay, so what is left there? So let's say it is Q. They asked us quality factor. So let's say it is omega L by R. Fine. What is omega now? Omega is 2 pi F. What is L? 2 pi F. L, let's write that. Divided by R. Understand that? Now, whether we have F given there, do we have F given there? No, but we have found out F naught. So when we know only F naught, we are supposed to take F naught only. Okay, so which means that we are taking omega naught. So this means that what we are finding out is quality factor at resonance. They have not told particularly that we have to be finding out the quality factor at resonance. But with the given that data, that is what is possible with variable frequency circuit. Understand that? So just substitute this stuff, parameters, so you'll get F naught as 159.15 K, and you'll have L as 100 milli, R is 1 K, so that's 1000. So this implies that R Q naught is 100. You take that. Okay, Q naught is a number, mind you, with no units. And this particular problem is giving us a Q naught, which is fairly good, a big number. Understand that? Okay. Next, what we need to find out, the fourth one, what they've asked us, the half power frequencies. Okay, so this is something we shall spend some time on. Fine. Yeah, what they've asked is the half power frequencies. So in the last session, we have found the equations for omega 1 and omega 2. Equations for omega 1 and omega 2 we have found out. So you can find out omega 1 and omega 2, and you can say F is omega 1 by 2 pi and F2 is omega 2 by 2 pi. This is one way of dealing with it. So you have to, for this, you have to remember the equations for omega 1 and omega 2. Okay. There is another way of doing this. What is that? Just see here. I've explained you this earlier. Okay, now this is what we have. Fine. Then you can get this. Fine. So this is F naught. So if this is I, this is going to be I naught, right? And if we come down by 3 dB, so this is I naught by root 2. Fine. So what they are asking us to find out is the half power frequencies F1 and F2. So this is F1 and F2 is what they've asked us to find out. Now let's understand that we have this as this is bandwidth. Everybody's okay with this, right? So this is bandwidth. Fine. Now what is this? What did we call this as? This is delta F, and this is also delta F. Is everybody okay with that? Okay. So what does this imply? Your bandwidth from this figure, I'm writing because this is the first time I'm using this concept. Okay. From the figure, bandwidth is given by 2 delta F. Yes. Now, we know the bandwidth also. What is bandwidth given by bandwidth of a series RLC circuit in terms of F? This is, let's say, F2 minus F1. This can even be given by F2 minus F1, and that is R by 2 pi L. So what does this imply now? This implies that our delta F is actually R by 4 pi L. Understand? And if we substitute R and L, okay, after substitution, you can show the substitution there. After substituting R and L, we'll get our delta F to be 795.77 hertz. So to find delta F, we are doing this. And bandwidth is 2 delta F, mind you. So once you have delta F with you, okay, so how we can express my F1 and F2? Therefore, F1 is what? See here, everybody, this is F1, okay? F1 is F0 minus delta F. F0 minus delta F would give you F1. So it is F0 minus delta F. Okay? That is one thing. Then what is F2 with that? What is F2? Here, F2 is F naught, F naught here is F2, so it's F naught plus delta F. Okay, show the substitutions and you can get your answers to be this. What is that? F1 is 158.35 kilohertz. Okay, and this is 159.95 kilohertz. Okay, so this is how we can find out F1 and F2, the half power frequencies. What else is asked there after finding out? So they have asked us the bandwidth. Okay, so bandwidth we have not found out yet. So we had taken bandwidth there, but we didn't find out bandwidth. Okay. So that's the fifth one they're asking us, the bandwidth. So bandwidth can be taken as 2 delta F since you have delta F, or you can take that as R by 2 pi L. Fine. So find out that and keep your answer. See what is your bandwidth. I don't have the calculated value there. So you can say, therefore, bandwidth is, okay, write that in this box. It would be in terms of kilohertz. Okay, Fine then. So this is what I wanted to give you. So if you don't want to follow this this method for F1 and F2, you can always do this. What is that? In the last class, okay, we have found out the expressions for half power frequencies. That is expressions for omega 1, omega 2. See here? So you can use these equations to find out omega and omega 2, and then you can convert that omega 1 and omega 2 into the frequencies F1 and F2. Fine. So you can even use these frequencies, the equations for omega 1 and omega 2 directly to do the problem. So if you don't want to remember this, this is easier way out. Okay. Yeah. Fine. So let's move on to the next problem. Anyways, I'll be uploading this. You can copy the problem then. But I'm explaining the problem properly. Okay, in detail I'm explaining. Just listen to that. Fine. You can copy the problem later on. Anyways, I'll be explaining you the problem, and I'll be giving the problem in brief in the solution also. Fine. So let's see the next problem, which is here, the fourth one. What is the problem telling? Everybody observe. What is the problem telling? In series RLC circuit with variable capacitance. So in the last three problems that we have done, the variable parameter was frequency. Okay. Now for the first time, we are finding a circuit where the capacitance is variable. What I mean is this. You have R, you have L, and you have C. Okay. This is a series RLC circuit, but how it is different from the problem that we have solved so far? Here, the capacitance is happening to be a variable entity, which means that R, L, and the frequency here are all constants. Fine. Now, next see here. What is it telling? The current is at maximum value with capacitance of 20 microfarads. So since we are varying the capacitance, okay, let me write that. Let me bring in this also. So I'm not getting those straight lines, so I thought I should do this. What they are telling is this. You have a circuit where the capacitor is variable. So this is capacitor now. Fine. So you have the current. Okay. And that current is becoming maximum. See, that current is maximum. Fine. When C is, when the capacitance is 20 microfarads, that means what? This is C naught, everybody, we know, right? This is C naught. So current is maximum when capacitance is 20 microfarads, means this C naught is 20 microfarads, mind you. Everybody's okay with that? Okay, this is how we need to analyze the problem. C naught is 20 microfarads. Now, the current reduces to 0.707 times. Anybody would like to talk about that? What is 0.707 here? I didn't explain the things in that regard. What is 0.707? Anybody, can you unmute? What is point?
Sir, Im by root 2.
Huh?
Im by root 2, sir.
Good, good. It is Im by root. Zeeshan, right? Zeeshan, yes, you answered. Good, man.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. It's 0.707 means it's 1 by root 2 only. So this is another way of explaining the thing. See here. I said, see here. So if you take this point coming down by 3 dB, fine. We were telling that the I naught here would be I naught by root 2. Understand? It also means it is 0.707 times I naught. Everybody understand that? At half power frequencies, your I naught is I naught by root 2. Or in other words, it is 0.707 times I naught. 0.707 is what? Your 1 by root 2. Understand that? Now, let's take this. Okay, so it is 0.707 times the maximum value with capacitance of 30 microfarads. Now, Zeeshan, can you take again? Zeeshan, can you again take this question?
Yes, sir.
They are saying capacitance is 30 microfarads. So what is this 30 microfarads? They say that it is 0.707 times the maximum value at capacitance of 30 microfarads. Can you tell me what is that 30 microfarads there?
C naught, sir, I guess.
No.
C1.
It's maximum, C1. No,
it is C. At 20 microfarads,
It's IM.
Maximum. Okay. It could either be C1 or C2. Whether it is C1 or C2, Zeeshan, just look at that and tell me. It is C1 or C2 is something that we know now. Whether this is C1 or C2, how to make out? Anybody?
C2,
exactly. How we can say that it is C2, not C1? See,
because C1 is capacitance increases.
It is greater than 20 microfarads. Isn't it?
It so increases
that part
on the x-axis.
We need to look at. Okay. So here is your C1. Yeah, let me write that. This is your C1. Okay. And this is your C2. And they have given us a capacitance value. Okay, at which the I is becoming 0.707 times the current, the maximum current. So that means it could even be C1 or it could even be C2. But it is they say that it is 30 microfarad. So it has to be C2. It cannot be C1 because it is greater than C0. Understand that? So it is 30 microfarads. Everybody getting this? Now, what else is explained there? Find the values of R and L. Okay, since capacitor is variable, okay, we need to be finding out the values of R and L. And also, here, what is the bandwidth of the circuit? If the supply voltage is this, what is the supply voltage? This seems to be something new. We have not seen this type of a supply voltage. It says it is 20 sine 6.28 into 10 power 3 T volts. This is how the given voltage source is. Now, what you should understand here is when C is variable, F is constant. When C is variable, F is constant. So that F is not given. Okay. So this particular thing, see, I've written right. So this particular thing would help me to get my F naught. How is that? Consider V applied V equal to 20 sine 6.28 into 10 power 3 T volts. Okay. You have to compare this with a standard sinusoidal wave. Anybody who knows what is standard sinusoidal wave? Anybody? You have to compare this. Comparing with the standard sinusoidal wave.
V is equal to Vm sin omega t.
Yes?
Vm sin omega t.
Tell me. It's A sin 2 pi f naught t, you can say, or you can say omega naught t. So if you compare this V with the standard V, this is also sinusoidal wave. This is also sinusoidal wave. What is A? A is 20. Okay. What is omega naught? Omega naught is 6.28 into 10 power 3. What is it? It is radians per second. Now, if you have to obtain F naught, what we can do, if we have to obtain F naught, so F naught is omega naught by 2 pi, and that happens to be 1 kilohertz. They have not asked us to find out F naught, but this F naught would be of help in the things that we'll be dealing with. F naught we found out. Now, current is maximum at resonant frequency, they are saying. Sorry. The current is maximum with C equal to 20 microfarads. Understand that? So, what is that equal to? So now we cannot say omega naught. Just we can just avoid this naught here. See, you see this? Let me write this again. You can say this is omega, and you can say this is F. Why am I doing that, anybody? Why I'm not interested in calling this as omega? Because I'm not dealing with a circuit where frequency is variable. So F is 1 kilohertz. So let's not say omega naught or F naught, because we have C naught. When we have C naught, I cannot talk about F naught there. Understand? Now, they have asked us to find L and C. Now, can you give me an equation? Can you give me an equation which gives the relation between F naught, L, and or F and C? Somebody has unmuted unknowingly and you are making talk there. You are talking there. Please stop that and concentrate. Now, what is the equation which will have these three parameters? Anybody remember that? They've asked us to find out L and C. We have F with us. So, can you give me the equation for this? Anybody? Let me tell you what it is. Since current is, or let's say, since the circuit is at resonance, register number 120, don't do that. Circuit is at resonance at C naught equal to 20 microfarads implies RF is 1 by 2 pi root L C naught. So this is something one should understand. We had not done this earlier. Fine. We have to do this in this fashion. Fine. Now how to find out? Now we know C naught. We know C naught. We know F. So only unknown is L. So how can I do that? So therefore, what I can do is, I can do F square 1 by 2 pi square, and I can get rid of this, what? Square root. So L is equal to what? L is equal to 1 by 2 pi F whole squared into C naught. Okay. So just substitute the things and get me the answer. What would be the answer for this? It would be L equal to, just copy this. You can do it later on, calculations and all. 1.2665 millihenry. Before I forget, let me tell you, we are meeting at 2:30 in the afternoon, everybody. We are meeting at 2:30 in the afternoon for the interactive session, wherein I'll be calling five students, okay, according to the register numbers, and I'll have interactions with you. And while I'm interacting, I'll just be evaluating how good you have understood the things, okay, and I'll be allotting marks also. Fine, I hope you know about it. If you don't know, I'm telling you now. Fine. Now let's find out C. Those who have not given attendance, you can give it now. Yeah. Let me go with C now. How to find out C? So we found out L. How to find out C? Okay. So we have L with us. Right. We have L with us. We need to find out R now. C is already given. Sorry. Yeah. R we need to find out. Okay. So for that, what we can do? We need to do this. You have to, suppose we want a relation consisting of R, L, C means you have this here at half power points. At half power points. What is true at half power points? Anybody? At resonance, we know. At half power points, what is true? Anybody who want to answer this? At half power points, what is true? Anybody? Okay, Suhana, can you answer that? Suhana, can you unmute yourself and answer? Suhana, you are there. Register number 94.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's, at half power points, what is true? Do you know? At resonant frequency, impedance is equal to resistance. At resonance frequency. At half power frequencies, what is true? Anybody else? So Suhana does not know. Tanuja, do you know? Tanuja, 103. Do you know? Who will answer this? Give it a try.
Sir, reactance equal to resistance.
Reactance is equal to the resistance. Very good. So, what is that? How does it look like now? Reactance means here. Reactance would be equal to resistance. That is omega L minus 1 by omega C would be equal to the resistance, let's say. Plus or minus R, let's say. Okay. So since C is variable, which C do we know? Do we know C1 or C2? We know C2, right? So I can write this as omega L minus 1 by omega C2, and this is R. Why we took C2? Since C2 is given. Otherwise, I would have taken C1. Understand? So how many unknowns are there now? C2 is known, L is known, only R is to be known. Okay. So therefore, R is equal to. Therefore, R is equal to what? You can just substitute the equation, substitute the parameters here, and you can obtain. L we know, C2 is given, L is something that we have found out. Omega is something that we obtained. Okay, by the given expression of for the voltage. So R you would get to be 2.652 ohms. Understand this? Now, they also have asked us to find out the bandwidth. Yes, have they asked us to find out the bandwidth? Let me check. Yeah, what is the bandwidth of the circuit? They've asked. What is bandwidth given by now? The bandwidth is given by R by 2 pi L. Okay, you can just substitute that here. So this implies that our bandwidth is 333.26 hertz. Okay, just copy this much. We will take some more problems in our next session. Okay, so if you have any thing to discuss regarding